I have a 17-year-old brother. He saw me graduate high school and he saw me graduate college. I know that I'm the one that he saw and he said, I can do that too.
Hello, and welcome to the Michael and Susan Dell Foundation's podcast. I'm Susan Dell. Today, we're going to hear two fascinating stories from our Dell Scholars Program. For nearly 14 years, this program is focused on helping low-income, first-generation students graduate from college. The Foundation's Oscar Sweeten Lopez has been with the Dell Scholars for over a decade. Oscar recently sat down with Esmeralda and Margarita, two remarkable alumni of the program, who have inspiring stories of their journey to college graduation and beyond. I hope you enjoy these incredible young women and their stories. Thanks for listening.
Hello, my name is Oscar Sweeten Lopez, and I'm the president of the College Success Tools and the former leader of the Dell Scholars Program. As a student that was first in my family to go to college, there's a lot of shared experiences from what I was able to see our Dell Scholars go through. And so that really, I think, helped in terms of, you know, how we structured our program and just tried to really understand the needs of what the students are facing when they are venturing off, you know, in pursuit of that degree and being the pioneers in their families in many cases. So today we're really honored to have a couple of those professionals now who have gone through that journey, who are in the world of work and who are doing some amazing things. Let me introduce our guests first, and I'm just going to have you guys each tell us a little bit more about yourself. So Margarita, let me just begin with you.
My name is Margarita Sevilla. I am from San Antonio, Texas. I am a 2009 Dell Scholar. I went to the University of Texas at Austin, and I currently work at Kip Austin Connections Elementary with Kip Austin Public Schools.
Thanks, Margarita. Thank you for joining us today. Esmeralda, tell us more about yourself.
Of course. My name is Esmeralda Mireles, and I am a 2012 Dell Scholar. I'm from the Rio Grande Valley, the southernmost tip of Texas, from a small town called Far. And I currently work at the Dell Zeidan Medical Center at the University of Texas at Austin.
Let me just, kind of start the conversation off. Tell us more about, you know, where you grew up. What was that like? And how did college factor into your plans, you know, as you were growing up? Or when did that begin to factor into your plans? Margarita, I'd love to hear from you.
So I grew up in San Antonio. I didn't start thinking about college until I went to middle school. I think in elementary school, nobody ever spoke to us about college. It was just go to school, do your work, interact with your peers, and that was it. I knew that my teachers must have done something to become teachers, but they never really spoke to us about, I went to college, I went to this university. I never really heard about that until I went to middle school, where different outreach programs came to our school and started speaking to us as seventh graders about the importance of going to college and how it could be accessible. I think that a lot of us thought that we couldn't because of where we came from. And so that was basically the first moment of like, I think I want this. My parents never made it a goal for us. They didn't go to college. They had very little education. They weren't against it whatsoever, but they never really spoke to us about it. So I think I just got this new idea of what college could be when I started middle school.
Esmeralda, tell us more about your experience and, you know, not just growing up and going to school, but your hometown. Again, when did college really enter the picture for you as something that you knew that you wanted to pursue and attain?
Well, I grew up in the Rio Grande Valley, and I really didn't start thinking about college until middle school, like Margarita said, because you're just going through the motions. Where you grew up, you know, survival was your mantra, and you just thought about the next meal because that's what your parents had to go through. And it seemed like college was this point that you weren't able to reach, and it didn't hit me until I got into high school. I believed that I could, you know, research different colleges, different opportunities, because my teachers believed in me.
So let's talk a little bit about going to college. I'd like to hear more about what was that experience like between you and your family, you know, picking up and moving away from home to a foreign university, in many cases, you know, a new land. How did that play out for you guys?
My mom, I believe she did not know how to react because she didn't have a child or a relative go off to college. And I think it was quite shocking for her. Nonetheless, she was very excited. It was nerve-wracking for me, knowing that the university I was going to go to had a higher enrollment population than my entire small town. My siblings were, you know, we looked to each other as role models, and whenever one of us pushes further, we're right behind them, or we want to do more. You know, we want more for our family. And like Margarita said, we want to be able to provide more for our mom in ways we weren't able to growing up. Being on the college campus was a culture shock. Seeing different people from different backgrounds, perceptions, experiences, you know, it opened you up to be able to collaborate and innovate in many different ways that you never could back home. It definitely challenged you to develop a new set of survival skills. So overall, I think it was amazing, yet and somehow a little intimidating, but overall it was one of the best experiences I've ever had.
And Margarita, being in San Antonio, geographically you're not that far from UT and where you went to college, but what was that experience like for your family, and not only in your experience, but then is that a common experience for other students from similar kinds of backgrounds as yourself?
I remember my mom crying when they dropped me off at the dorm when the semester started. I will tell her, Mom, I'm like 45 minutes away. You're going to be fine. Like, I'm going to miss you. I love you, but you're going to be fine. But she cried and she cried. So that was interesting for me to see them be scared and be nervous for me. I didn't last a week before I decided to go home and visit. So that just told me, like, this is going to be a struggle and you are going to have to figure out how you're going to get through it. You cannot go home every weekend.
I mean, it's not easy for anybody, regardless of where you're from. If, you know, if your parents have gone to college, it's always hard for, you know, for you to, you know, have your children leave the nest, if you will. But how do you think your experience compared to maybe some of your peers at UT who did come from families where college was an expectation, not a dream necessarily?
It was definitely a different experience. Where I went to high school, we all came from very similar socioeconomic backgrounds. Whenever I would meet people, their parents' expectation was, you're going to college no matter what. I didn't come from that. I didn't have that. So they already had someone at home. They already had a resource at home that they could always go to, which was different from what I didn't have, because I would call my parents, but I couldn't ask them for help because they won't know what to do. And also, I don't want to worry them.
So everybody's going to struggle. I mean, again, no matter what your background, you're not kind of hit it out of the park every single time, every day in college. And so, you know, struggles and challenges are a natural part of life for everybody. But, you know, tell me more about how did you guys manage that struggle or some of those challenges? And how did the Dell Scholars Program come in to really help support you through those?
It was definitely a struggle to ask for help. I think the first semester was definitely one of the hardest for me. But when the Dell Scholars Program asked me for the mid-year check-in, for me, that was like, okay, someone else other than my parents is checking in on me. They want to know how my grades are going, what I'm doing. That's pretty cool that they want to follow up, you know? And so I remember one of the first interactions, I remember I couldn't upload a document. That was, to me now it sounds so trivial, but the fact that I was just able to call someone, that just told me they're here to help you.
And Esmeralda, how about your experience and again, overcoming a challenge, and how was the program able to step in and be a part of that support network for you?
I think it was really nice to understand that the Dell Scholarship went beyond a check. They didn't write us a check and said good luck, and then we had to check in at the end of the semester. They guided you. And there are multiple situations where I felt like, you know, all of this is a little too much. My family was going through a really rough time, especially my mom with her health issues. And I was very close to getting evicted. I remember the slip being on my door, and I didn't know where to turn. You know, growing up, we didn't, you know, your family and your superiors tell you you shouldn't ask for favors. You should work for everything that you want to attain. But at that moment, I felt helpless. So when I reached out to Dell Scholars Program, I got assistance, and it provided me shelter. It provided me a place to really focus on my studies and to block out all the noise and the insecurities and the stress that I had. One really small example are check credits. And what those credits did, they supplied you with textbook credits to be able to purchase your textbooks needed for class. And I was able to be prepared. I was already ahead, prepared to listen to the presentations and to the lecture, and they're invested in you and you mean something to them, especially for someone who wants to walk you and guide you through your academic years. Knowing that somebody was there just to even talk to me, just to listen, was not only did that help me, it helped my family situation. And I don't know if I could ever repay that, but it meant a whole lot.
So many of our Dell scholars, when they complete their degree and they go off into, you know, that first career after school, there's a tangible way of being able to kind of measure that type of success. But what's very difficult to measure is the impact that you have as a college graduate within your own family, within your own community. It's really hard to be able to measure how someone like you and Esmeralda, you know, really can motivate that next generation of students to pursue a similar path as you did. What do you think you as a role model, how has that influenced maybe those around you?
As a teacher, I always hope that my students are learning as much as they can, but that they also take the life lessons in the classroom. I just hope that I'm being the role model that they need. So I'm hoping that they can see that their goals, their dreams are attainable. And I talk to them about it, and I hope that they really take that to heart to say, I can do that. I can do more than that. In my personal and my family life, I'm hoping and I think that I'm making an impact because I have a 17-year-old brother. He's a senior this year, and he has been thinking about college since middle school as well. He saw me graduate high school, and he saw me graduate college. But just the fact that he's thinking about it, to me, that makes me happy because I know that I'm the one that he saw and he said, I can do that too. That just makes me really proud of myself and what I've done. But it also just makes me proud of him for making that decision because of Dell Scholars Program and all of the knowledge that I have acquired through the years. I'm able to tell him about it. And now he's going to be a college graduate. Can't wait for that.
You know, you can be a role model at any age. My siblings see that as we come home and the way that we're still working towards our careers, because you are their flesh and blood. And if there's any person that they can look to, it's going to be you. My mom, we were just discussing at the dinner table, and she just saw the confidence within, you know, her children that one day I got a text message and it was a picture of her student ID at the local community college. So she was motivated to go back to school, and she was just so excited. You know, it's such unfamiliar territory, but the fact that her children, you know, the tables have turned, her children were able to help her in immeasurable ways. And that made me so happy because she went herself because of her children and she got her degree.
As you think back on, you know, being a Dell Scholar, what that's meant to you, what advice would you give to other young people like yourselves?
I would say that no matter what you're going through, you're going to get through it. It is hard. I'm not going to sugarcoat that. It is hard, but it is something that's going to make their lives better. Not only are you getting a piece of paper, you're meeting people with different stories. And I think that that is the way to change your mindset and to just learn, not just from what you learn in the classroom, but from those interactions and others' experiences.
You know, my advice would be, don't be afraid to be different and take the first step to reach your goals. Don't be ashamed that you had to eat the same meal for the entire week. Don't be ashamed that you had to wear the same clothes. You know, you had to work really hard for your funds. All of this has built you to where you are right now. And the Dell Scholars Program, and along with Margarita and myself and this entire team, we want to kind of destroy that perception that college is not achievable by you, because it certainly is. Education is definitely a foundation for success, and every single day is a new opportunity for you to go out there and really try your best and surprise yourself.
Well, Margarita and Esmeralda, thank you so much for being here today and talking with me. Our hope is that other students will hear this and be inspired to pursue their path towards their college degree and to employment afterwards as a way to overcome their circumstances, just like all of you, and to feel empowered and inspired by your stories. So thank you again for sharing.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you, Oscar, Esmeralda, and Margarita, for sharing your stories today. Students from the Dell Scholars Program never cease to inspire and amaze me. I hope you feel the same way. Thank you for listening. To learn more about the Dell Scholars Program and the impact of college completion, visit impact.msdf.org/completion. Until next time.